Hi everyone, I just thought I'd give you an update on the greenhouse and what's going on here. As you can see, we have quite a bit of snow, which is lovely, but it's going to be quite interesting when it thaws. And so I'm just going to go take you inside the greenhouse. Now, at this temperature, right now it's actually quite a balmy +2 here, but up to about -5. Our greenhouse is entirely heated by our geothermal climate battery system. There's no battery this year because we didn't store any heat, but just from the Earth's temperature, you can see we used lots of recycled materials. These are from a little canopy we had at the old farm, pulled out the windows. They add extra really nice ventilation when we need it. Right now we don't. And as you can see, I'm going to take you around the outside. I dug a bit of the snow because it was so deep. It's a 4-foot wall and it was completely covered about a foot up beyond the 4-foot wall. So I've relieved a little bit of that snow so we can let more light in. We are finally starting to get some sun. Earlier I didn't bother removing the snow. It provides insulation because we just didn't get enough light, which is why we have supplemental light inside when we're growing stuff. So we don't have a lot this year because, like I said, I don't know if you've seen a previous video, but we didn't get finished until November 7th and it was -7. So I actually had to thaw out the ground in order to use it. You can see our fans there. There's one there and one on the far end. I haven't even cut the tubes down yet. This greenhouse is by no means finished. It's more like finished to functional, I'd call it. So this is the new seed bed. I haven't planted a lot of fresh seeds yet. This is corn salad, and then there's some mixed stuff in there, some mixed muesli sort of greens and some onions. The mixed muesli is coming up, and I also have some of the corn salad I can see that's already up. And that was freshly planted a week ago. So this is the center bed. This is where I keep the stuff I dug up and transplanted and then overwintered. So I got kale. All this kale you're seeing here is actually new growth. And right now I don't have the lights on, but 2 months of the year we don't get a lot of light. So it'll hold stuff, but it doesn't grow. So I have some light. They're only 40 watts each. And this beautiful little plant right here, I also dug up, Bloody Dock. And it makes great salads. This is all new growth. As I said, it was -7 when we finally got the greenhouse plastic on, only one layer at that point. So I transplanted anything that I had covered with Remay and plastic, a few things that were perennial and would make it if I got them in the greenhouse, and just transplanted them. It was like -7, but the two layers kept the ground just was freezing the very top of it. And so most of the leaves on this one had died back, except for two leaves in the center. But it's started to grow really good now because the light level has started to come up and the heat level started to come up. So that's growing here. The greenhouse is super messy right now because I'm in the middle of planting and doing multiple projects. So this here is where we keep our firewood, and this is the stove, which is not going right now. We only need that when it gets really cold, just to keep it above freezing. So this bed here along the back is all fruit trees, fruit bushes. There's also some bulbs underneath there that will be coming up. It's February 6th today, 2022, and you can see that these black currants here are starting, they're flowering currants, starting to bud. There's some buds there. And the little mini nectarines looking really good. That's what that is. These are cherry bushes, miniature blackberries we've got here. This one is grafted plums and nectarine. You can actually see the buds on it. Look at those. So we're going to get some flowers pretty quickly. I don't know if that's too... It's not the best camera here. So there you have it. You can hear Those are sweet williams down there. And the ones in the house are actually, I grew these from seed last year. The ones in the house are actually putting on some buds. This was a tiny celery, which is starting to grow now. And the kale is starting. I lost two. Transplanting them so late, I didn't have time to get good root growth. But everything you see here is actually fresh growth. I've now picked off most of the old stuff. This is all brand new. And there's some parsley. And then these little tiny plants right here, they look a little worse for wear, but they're actually starting to go pretty well. These are spinach. So these were teeny tiny ones that I found were growing in the greenhouse frame. This frame was just sitting on the ground, and I had some, they were really tiny. And I thought, well, they might transplant. And they did. It took a long time for them to get going, though. Next year I'm going to do a flat of them ready to go. Over here is a little mini compost pile I've got. It's not very deep. It needs another foot before it'll actually start to really be active, and then I'll give it a good watering. But you can see the soil temp here. I'll just show you the soil temperature thermometer. I don't know if you can read that. Let's see. It is 52 degrees right now. The soil temp. Anyway, so that's it. This is the greenhouse, and it survived the winter for the most part. The two-layer plastic kept the condensation sort of between. I don't know if you can see it. And I actually have a few little, I have some plans to put a drain along each one for next year when it's permanent. This is just temporary plastic, whatever I had to do a second layer. And it's going to have a drain that just opens up and lets the condensation, but it's really awesome. It's worked out really well to keep condensation off my plants. Like, it's perfect humidity in here right now. Not too much, not too little. And this right here is our water barrel. If you can see it, I'll walk back a little bit here. But water barrel, and underneath there's just sort of a frame. There is some compost in there as well, but very nice in here right now. Pleasant to work. And this is the hose we used for whenever I want to fill the water barrel. I give the compost and everything a good watering. It's those expandable hoses, and so we can use it even when it's freezing, and it just gets stored in here so that, you know, it's ready to go whenever I need it. And now that's worked really well. So this year we got lots of finishing to do. I just used this old corrugated plastic I had from a greenhouse we took apart at the old farm, and it's already starting to white and stuff, but it worked fine for this year. The front is getting replaced with glass anyway. I've got the glass, I just couldn't get to it to get it done in time, so it will get replaced. I have one door on the end there, and then the two windows on each side open up, but I've got bubble wrap over them right now for the temperature on the one, and just regular plastic. I'm trying out a couple different ideas. And then this ceiling is going to be the height for the winter, but it's actually going to be coroplast, and it's going to fold open so that we can get the full height to get more air circulation. And there'll be an automatic vent in the end of each one at the main height there. So the plan is that the coroplast will go all the way to the ceiling and then fold down on the outer edges, letting the hot air rise up there, and then go out through the two vents. But in the summertime, that's going to be useful. Wintertime, the less area we have to heat, the better. So it will have this lower ceiling, which is still plenty high, but a heat curtain is going to be made next year as well. So that's the plans.